Hi there. Today on Typical Books, we're going to talk about some of the new releases coming out in horror for August. First, though, Scarlett R. Algie's new book, Bleed Through and Other Small Horrors, that's just come out now from a press I don't recognize, Cold War Radio. Now, this is special to me in that Scarlett has edited a story that's forthcoming of mine, and one of my favorite editors to work with, actually. She might have touched some other stories of mine for the same sort of venue where this story is coming out. I'm keeping it hush-hush at the moment because it hasn't seen the light of day yet. It hasn't fallen off the shelves, as it were, quite yet. So I'm gonna keep mum on that. But I've only ever worked with one editor that wasn't a total doll to work with. Every editor that's ever touched my work, and Tobin Elliott especially, who edited Nightface and some of my other short stories, I had a similar relationship with Scarlett, all email for the most part, but she really seemed to get what I was getting at and understood that I was learning as much as she was teaching when editing my work. So I really enjoyed that. So Bleed Through and Other Small Horrors, a collection of short stories. Some of them are a little longer, but there's quite a few in here, so I suspect some may be microfiction. So looking forward to this. Out today. Kind of cool, huh? As far as new stuff, I've been running sort of an experiment on a new social media platform. New to me, maybe not new to everybody else, but I've been doing an A to Z alphabet of horror over on TikTok. So if you are on TikTok, you can check out Typical Books over there too. And it's just something that might come to visit here in one long video of all the letters of the alphabet. I'm right now spreading it amongst 13 days because conveniently when you chop our alphabet in half, we get 13 nice installments. So I'm doing kind of an A to Z of horror over there. And in big, crazy, fun news, Dead Air Podcast will be resurrected shortly. We're doing a summer fun hit. We had lined up a couple kind of dreary Asian horrors and remakes and stuff, but we decided to kind of nix a lot of that, and we're going to come back with an experiment and see how we like it. Probably every 2 weeks we'll see how it goes. I don't know, we'll see how it goes, but right now we're doing a fun summer hit of 1978. So yeah, exciting stuff. If you can guess what it is, leave it down in the comments below. But now, on with new releases for August from Horror Writers Association authors. Now, I was sure that I had this in here, Book of Horror, Anatomy of Fear on Film, Book of Horror, an in-depth guide to the scariest movies ever made, including references to more than 100 classic and contemporary horror films. Beautiful black and white illustrations and revealing infographics, it examines the how and why that these films continue to frighten us. This is the Book of Horror, The Anatomy of Fear on Film by Matt Glasby, out from White Lion, and it's coming out in September. Writing in the Dark, Tim Waggoner, Raw Dog Screaming Press. This is coming out in September as well, and I'm looking forward to this. I always like horror craft books, and that's what this is, a comprehensive textbook devoted to the craft of writing horror fiction. Writing in the Dark offers advice, guidance, and insights on how to compose horror stories and novels that are original, frightening, entertaining, and well-written. So I'm really looking forward to that. This is some more stuff coming out in September. It didn't strike me that this is a YA novel at first. Reluctantly, Macy Donner agrees to a family vacation to please her father. Beset by ominous weather, power outages, and hulking shadows heralded by terrifying screams from the darkness, Macy realizes that she's not equipped for the horrors of the abandoned haunted house, or for its long-buried secrets, secrets that want to kill her. That is from J.P. Barnett from Evolve Publishing. And yeah, I didn't realize until at the end, I kind of looked it up a little bit to see the wherefore of that, and I believe it is YA. I had mentioned Shadowy Natures, Stories of Psychological Horror, that will be out in the beginning of September. And this comes from Rowland Books by Rebecca Rowland, Dark Ink Books. 21 stories of serial killers and sociopaths, breakdowns, and bad decisions crafted by authors as diverse as their writing styles. Shadowy Natures leads fans of psychological horror down dark and treacherous roads to destinations that they will be too unsettled to leave. Normally that psychological horror chases people away. I am the one who is susceptible to the magnet that they are saying that this book is. So I'm looking forward to that. It Will Just Be Us by Joe Kaplan. Sam Wakefield lives in a haunted house. A decaying mansion built on the edge of a swamp filled with echoes of the past. But when her pregnant sister arrives, a new ghost appears, that of a faceless boy bent on terrorizing her. As her sister's due date approaches, Sam must uncover the mysteries of Wakefield Manor before they bring new life into a house marked by death. I'm not one for that sort of story. I'm all for women's stories in horror, but not the story of mothers and childbirth and things like that. Very rarely does that work for me as a plot, so we'll see. I don't know. The next one coming up is ending up on a lot of people's TBRs. The House That Fell from the Sky by Patrick Delaney. This comes out from Oblivion Publishing. And I don't know. It's not out until the 1st of September, but it seems to be on a lot of people's piles right now. So I suppose ARCs are being proliferated. When a mysterious mansion appears overnight in the heart of an impoverished city, three friends must face their fears when one of their own risks her life to find out if the house is real or merely an illusion. Very interesting, and it reminds me of Abattoir in a way, if you've ever seen that film. There were a lot of books in this time around, so I was just forewarning, I've got quite a few to go. My throat's already dry. The Ninja's Blade by Tori Eldridge. This at first didn't strike me as horror, but I was intrigued. Comes up from Polis Books, an imprint of Agora Books. Lily Wong, a Chinese-Norwegian modern-day ninja, has more trouble than she's bargaining for when her controlling grandparents arrive in Los Angeles from Hong Kong at the same time that she goes undercover in a dangerous world of youth sex trafficking. So I don't know about the Chinese-Norwegian modern-day ninja, but I do know that I am very terrified by the real crime horror story of underground, underage sex trafficking. So yeah, this piqued my interest. And out shortly by Tim Waggoner, Some Kind of Monster. This comes from Apex Publishing. Throughout her life, Angie has lost loved ones to stupid, meaningless deaths. Haven't we all? As an adult, she begins researching urban legends, hoping to find proof that something exists beyond our mundane world. In the end, she'll learn that reality isn't just darker than she thinks, it's some kind of monster. Yeah, that sounds super, super interesting. Tim Waggoner, that's two on this list. The same author, nonfiction and fiction. Dominion, an anthology of speculative fiction from Africa and the African Diaspora, edited by Ekpeki, Oghenechovwe, Donald, and Zelda Knight. This comes up from Aurelia Leo, and it's out in a couple weeks. I believe that it is in pre-order for hardcover. Dominion is the first anthology of speculative fiction and poetry by Africans and the African Diaspora. Among 13 tales, old gods rise, a pet robot is sent to mine an asteroid, and magicians time travel to Ngoni country to change history, among many other tales. And I had to kind of truncate all the descriptions. In a lot of anthologies, they'll describe every single story, and it's really hard to pick and choose. So I picked the first three the first two and the last one. But there are so many interesting sounding stories in this anthology that I highly recommend looking it up. Dust in Time by Mitch, and this is out now. Constable Riley Saunders thought the legend of Chandler Brackett was just folklore, but the century-old killer was very real, and he is back. This time, he's determined to secure his legacy in the small town of Hammett's Point, a community ravaged by sickness and its own terrible past. Ghost Dance by Betty Fry. And this is out now. All of these are out now. A killer haunts the powwow circuit, quietly assembling his spirit of Indian warriors as he searches for the ultimate sacrifice that will return his warriors to the material world. When a young boy is taken, his adoptive mother begins a desperate pursuit across the barren volcanic wasteland of the killer's path. And Unleashed by E.L. Jefferson. In a wooded suburb, the victim of a drunken midnight hit-and-run is left to die on the side of the road, a body horribly shattered. Their trauma surgeon is soon led down a dark and forbidden path of savage experimentation that unleashes creatures that have manipulated mankind for millennia. and will once again walk among us. Now, there's something about this that reminds me a bit of maybe Rabbit or something, or I don't know. There's something that is reminding me of other fiction I've read where somebody is experimented on against their will after an accident. And this is a self-published title, but I'm very interested to see where this goes. And finally, Negative Space by B.R. Yeager. This comes out from Apocalypse Party, which is a cool name for a publisher if I've ever heard one. Amid a small town suicide epidemic, four friends begin abusing a synthetic hallucinogen that imbues strange powers and conjures entities composed of thin black string. Their psyches begin to bleed into the material world, influencing reality in grave ways that could ruin them all. And that sounds like John dies at the end. It's some sort of strange, weird fiction going on there, and hopefully it hits horror peaks. So that is it for books that are coming out mainly in August, quite a few from September actually that are yet to come out that you can pre-order right now, and everything running the gamut from some YA to writer's craft, which I'm especially excited about. If you've got any of those books on your TBR, like I suspect many already have The House That Fell from the Sky on their list, if this helps add to your list, then I have done my job. If there's anything else that you're really anticipating right now, let me know in the comments below. Thank you very much for watching, and make sure that you have an ooky spooky day.